personally, honestly. Have you guys ever experienced that thing where you're in a group of people and they all have an accent, and then eventually you gain that accent? Well, I was hanging out with a friend of mine who runs a daycare recently, and I was surrounded by children, and I gained every speech impediment. Which is weird, because when I was a kid, I had a speech impediment too, where I couldn't pronounce my R's, but now I can totally say the N-word. So I think that's... I should probably preface it that way. I shouldn't. I got this haircut before the White Nationalist State, and I don't really know where to go now with it. Just have to make sure when I cover my eyes to see the sun, my hand doesn't go up too tall. That's all. I really have to prepare. Like, I have some black friends in Virginia before I moved here, and they, in my little group, they said I could say the N-word with them, but not gonna prove it now. Like, there's no... No, I'm not gonna drive without my license. You just get in trouble for that. No way. Although I'm white, I could probably get away with it. A lot of people think I'm more conservative than I am, just by looking at me, because I look like the enemy. So I understand. Like, close your eyes and think of the problem. Open your eyes, same picture. It's the exact same picture. I don't know, I have no idea how it turned out this way, that I just look like an evil superpower. I don't know, it's like when I was a child, I think I blew up my birthday candles wrong and then said I want superpowers, but like someone wasn't listening and now I look like the Third Reich. So it's weird. Like, I know I'm not racist, okay? And not my, some of my best friends' lives matter. And that is very... And just because the way I look, I get blamed. This is like the one thing I can complain about. I get blamed for gentrification every time I move. I just escape the suburbs, which I don't get enough credit for. Suburbs are just, it's a neighborhood of cul-de-sacs. Those are professionally made dead ends, and I made it out alive. And every time I move to a place with buildings, it's my fault there's a Starbucks nearby. Like, come on, man. Like, I lived in a small town where the space was just Casual Joe. Now every time I move to a big city, I'm Trader Joe, immediately. I get blamed for a building I can't afford to enter. I don't know how... This is a public library face at best. Those things are free. I love Starbucks. I should probably mention that. As progressives and liberals, we're supposed to support them extra hard now. Because after the Muslim ban, which by the way just got canned twice, awesome, that's right. Just got canned twice. The CEO of Starbucks said internationally he's going to start hiring refugees and people that have assisted the US militaries and employ them worldwide. And the Trumpers lost their goddamn minds. And now it started trending on like the Make America Great Again side of Twitter that we're all supposed to be afraid of terrorist baristas now. The scariest and worst career with the kindest, sweetest career ever just mashed together. Terrorist baristas. Don't go out with that woman. She's a murder nurse. I don't know how they're afraid of this. What are you afraid of? That they're going to be employed? That this person, this man, this woman is going to cut the white head of foam off your latte? It's called an Americano. We know what you are. Like, what are you expecting? Yes, actually, Trenta is 30 ounces. Our largest size is Meckett. Promise is 72. Yes, I'm screwing with you, racist. Get to the back of the line. What are you afraid of? Sincerely. And honestly, I like Alex Newman. I appreciate you guys like that joke, because now that we're actively fighting ISIS, still, I'm not sure if you know about this, but every intelligence community in the U.S. Nicknamed the execution cell instead of ISIS. They nicknamed it just to keep track of it. You know what they called it? ISIS Beatles. You wanna know why? Because two of the guys in it have British accents. That's it, that's the whole reason. They all agreed just to diminish one of the best bands humanity has to offer and just tag it to an execution cell inside of ISIS. Do you know the US military killed Lenin? In the execution cell, I should probably have pointed that out too. They nicknamed every person in the cell. ISIS Beatles, that is the worst cover band in history. Can you agree on that point? We've all heard their hit singles, Hey Jews, I Wanna Cut Off Your Hand, Twist and Shout Yourself Out of These Restraints, what else? Oblah de Oblah Allah, the bastardization of a religion. We all understand what music we shouldn't be listening to. Thank you, Squealer in the back. Like, I don't have faith, but I know Islamophobia is just a scare tactic. There's no, religion is not the problem. It's the people who interpret it. Faith can be beautiful. People are stupid assholes. Like, we're screwing it up. We were given something amazing. We made it awful. We were given the written language. Cool, here's Twitter. That's what we did with it. And now we're following it with emojis now, going back to, like, ancient Egyptians and iconography. Like, God damn it. What is happening right now? A woman sends me three dots and a smiley face. Like, am I getting water for our tribe, or do you want to screw? What are you doing? Eggplants. I'll play along, but it's confusing. Because if you misread the Quran, you might become a suicide bomber. Whoops. Just like you misread Harry Potter, you might become a Scientologist. And just like if you misread the Bible, you might watch Fox News. But these are risks we take. It's a joke. I watch Fox News all the time. Love blondes. Hello, I see you. My favorite thing about Fox News is what they invent every single holiday season. The holiday season is December, by the way. That's where all the real holidays are. There's no other real holiday. Let's stop kidding ourselves. Do you guys think Fat Tuesday is a real holiday? Do you guys celebrate the ancient Native American holiday of Mardi Gras? Mardi Gras? Have I been saying that wrong for years? I'm assuming it's Native American because we trick people with beads. So all of the best holidays... Not a fan of history, neither are they. All of the best holidays are right there in December. And this happened 3 years ago. Megyn Kelly, during her little holiday season, went on camera and said it is a proven fact that Jesus and Santa are both white. Have fun on NBC, Megyn. This is going to be a weird transition. But I don't know about this crowd, but I know I have a problem with half of that. Because Santa is white. Sorry, Mall of America, you are wrong. Santa is white. Show of hands, who can think of another race of person that could break into multiple homes in the same evening and not get arrested? Anyone else? Makes sense to me. He owns slaves. Let's be real. Santa's white. He lives in the North Pole, Chicago. Have you known white people to live in the south side of anything? Come on. I'll leave you this one. Trump didn't want to win. He just wanted to win a bet. And this is a bet no one won. No wonder he buries casinos into the ground. This is something he didn't want to win. He's a megalomaniac, and he has millions of dollars. And his victory party on election night was a fourth the size of Hillary's. That's how I know. I promise when Kanye wins in 2020, he's going to burn his name on the surface of the moon. That is what megalomaniacs with money do when they celebrate. And at Trump's party, he had a cash bar. Can we all agree that's the biggest F you to anyone you invite to a party, first of all? You don't want to win? I've been to weddings for friends and family, and I've seen a cash bar sign as soon as the pastor stands up because they don't have any objections. I'm like, goddamn right I do! They don't deserve love! That Michelin Ultra was $10! Goddamn it! Screw who's the destination wedding to? Screw Fiji and your square water bottles! No, I'm out. I'm out. He didn't want to win. He didn't want to win, and his campaign said, oh, Trump didn't want to jinx it. That should scare everyone else more than anything else about Trump. Our president is superstitious. You know where sexism and racism come from. You have a small dick and can't look at yourself in the mirror without seeing the shadow behind your eyes. We know where that comes from. We get it. But superstition? And he's in real estate. This means he's superstitious. That means if he sees a black cat on the sidewalk, he can't keep walking. He has to cross the street to, like, progress. But since he's a racist, he hates black cats for both reasons. You understand? He won't even grab that pussy. You understand? You ask this man when he's afraid of when the cameras are off and the doors are closed. He goes, Muslims and ghosts. He's a creepy, weird dude. It's like something out of Scooby-Doo. And then Steve Bannon rips his mask off, and it's still Steve Bannon. You understand? Man's in real estate, that means none of his buildings have a 13th floor. Cuz. No, I hate it. I hate that. It's a super scary number. favor, I want you to get rid of it. As a matter of fact, take that amendment out of the Constitution. So! So thank you guys for giving me 8 minutes, and good luck with the next 4 years. My name is David Carter.